Hello everybody, my name's Kim and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to use the tool presets in Toon Boom Storyboard Pro. A tool preset is basically a predefined brush or pencil tool that has specific characteristics, and you can quickly access these tool presets from the tool preset toolbar or by using shortcut keys on your keyboard. To open the tool preset toolbar, you can find it by going to Windows, Toolbars. All the way to the bottom, there's tool presets, and it will open up this tool preset toolbar over here. You already have some pre-made tool presets. In this case, you'll have a rough, a clean, a shading, and a revision tool preset already available for you to use. As you can see, I have a layout set up over here. I have a sketch that I want to trace, and I'm going to be using tool presets to trace this sketch. So I'm not actually going to use any of the ones that are already here. I'm going to make new ones. So as you can see, I have a couple of layers. My A layer is just a blank square filled with white in the back. Then I have my ref, which is my rough sketch. Then I have a BG line layer, which is going to be the line art for my background. I have a character color layer, which is going to be the fill for certain areas on my character, such as the hair and the sleeves and the collar. I have a character shade, which is going to be the shading on my character. And I've got character line, which is going to be the line art on my character. So I'm going to make a tool preset for each one of these layers over here. We can make a new tool preset by finding the brush we want to use first here in our tool properties. So I want to use a brush tool for this tool preset, so make sure your brush is selected. The lines are going to be around 15, and it's just going to be a solid black line. So make sure that you pick everything that you want your tool preset to have. Then go to create a new tool preset over here on your tool preset toolbar. This will automatically adopt whatever you have in your tool properties selected. So I'm going to name this brush tool set as my character line. Shortcut. Now this is basically if you want to create a keyboard shortcut for your tool preset. You'll see that there's a whole bunch over here up to number 9. I'm going to leave mine as no shortcut. But if you chose one of these, you'd be able to go into your preferences and actually assign a shortcut to whichever one you picked. Here we have color, so this is whether you wanted to adopt the color from your tool properties or not. And here we have layer. Now, what's really nice about this is that every time you select that tool preset, it will automatically select the layer that you're assigning to it as well. So there's no chance of you accidentally selecting the wrong layer and drawing on that wrong layer. Also, if you don't already have a layer with that name, it will create it for you when you use the new tool preset. We're going to be using a vector layer for this one. So I'm going to leave it on vector layer. This is just whether you want draw behind to be on or off and whether you want auto flatten to be on or off. Then up here you have the icon that represents your tool preset. You can actually create and upload your very own icons for this, especially if you don't want to go with one of the default icons. You can do it by opening this folder and opening the file that you want to use for your icon. I'm just going to go with a red brush for now. And I'm going to say OK. Now you'll see it's added an extra red brush on. The original one was for revision. This one's going to be character line. If I select another layer and then I click on this tool preset that I've added, you'll see it automatically goes and selects the right layer that I've assigned it to. And then I can begin to draw on that layer as needed. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add some more brushes for the other layers I have over here. There's just one that I really need to pay attention to, and that's my character shade, because this is actually a bitmap layer. So I have to make sure that when I create this one that it is created for a bitmap layer. So again, I'm going to go and I'm going to pick how I want my shading to look, what brushes I want, the maximum size, flow, and opacity. And then I'm going to go and create a new brush tool preset. And I'm going to make this one gray and call it character shade. I'm going to leave the color as is, and I'm going to make sure that it's on the character shade layer. And this time I'm going to change this to bitmap layer because it's going to be a bitmap layer. I'm going to leave everything else as is and say okay. And there our tool preset for my shade should pop up. At some point, you might decide that you want to edit the properties of some of these tool presets. If you click on this gear, you'll be able to see all the presets that you've created. Now you can pick the one that you want to do changes to. You can change the icons, what layer it's assigned to, whether it's vector or bitmap, whether draw behind or auto flatten is on, and you can also delete, import, and export brushes. It's important to know that if you edit anything in here, all you have to do is press OK to change these settings. However, if you actually want to change how the brush looks when it draws, you will have to change the settings first in the tool properties, then click on the gear, select the brush you want to change, and click update. If you happen to assign shortcuts to any of your tool presets, you can actually change the keyboard shortcut that's assigned to that preset by going into your Edit, Preferences, Tool Presets. Here you'll find all the presets that you can actually assign to your tools, and all you have to do is select them and apply a shortcut to these tool presets. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue to create two more tool presets for each of the layers I have left. And then I'm going to draw the sketch using my tool presets. I'll see you back here when I'm done. Okay, I'm back everybody, and I've done my sketch using my tool presets. As you can see, I've got different layers doing different things and having different tools being used on them. So that's how you go about using tool presets in Storyboard Pro. I hope that helped, and I'll see you next time.